Welcome here at the Crowdsourcing Week. We're having an interview here with Koen of Loyens & Loof. You're going to share your story in a couple of minutes on stage. What are you going to share?
Well, basically, like I said, my background is I'm a finance lawyer based in Brussels. In that fact, we knew that when we see clients who came with the crowdfunding campaigns which they wanted to launch, you have to get out of your comfort zone a bit, and you see that many areas of the law come in. For example, you've got IDs being launched with ways to IP infringements. You want to maybe patent your IDs. And some people, when they want to launch an equity or a debt-based campaign, you've got an whole range of financial regulatory compliance issues with regulators you have to look into, which if you want, like say, a services-based firm, they do not have these issues. So first of all, when they come to us, you analyze that, you say, okay, which product are you selling, what are you doing, and then you go into the legal implications. But we see that a lot of equity and lending-based platforms are willing to be developed, or existing platforms come to us. And there we either negotiate with the regulator, see what can be done, what cannot be done. Everybody has these little features that have to be touched upon, and then we see where you end up. How do we make a nice structure, which also makes that you can do an exit as an investor and as a venture capitalist to co-invest in that firm on a long basis.
And what do you think are the biggest challenges when you look at the law and crowdfunding to make it a sustainable model for the future?
Yeah, I think the main challenge will be the regulation. The financial regulation, at least in equity base, will we stick with the current rules and the bigger players conform with that and they become real investment companies going in a really regulated market? Or will maybe Europe take that step further? Do they want to have it innovative? Maybe we can probably have a launch of maybe also cowboy platforms going in there, but at least they spur the innovation. They will see. But what will the regulators do? We see different approaches in all countries. UK takes a very regulated approach. Belgium, personally, I think takes a very good approach where they limit amounts per investor. So they want to leave the economy. We'll see where it comes. We'll see where it goes. And we'll see. So the regulators play an essential part in the sustainability of the market.
And when you look at the crowdfunding platforms, in the Netherlands, there are lots of different platforms. And last year, we predicted that 2013 would be the year of the shakeout. So all the but when you look at the last months, I guess in 2013 the amount of platforms will double in the Netherlands in 1 year. How do you think? How can you protect also the consumer in picking the right platform?
Honestly, who knows? I had the same question preferred for the panel last year, so also ask them. I agree with the fact that little platforms emerge all over. How do you protect the consumer? Well, I mean, there are risks involved in the crowdfunding, and I think it will be a process going on where consumers have good or bad experiences. They share that. It's an open economy. Everybody is on Facebook. And I think just the market will guide you towards that platform which has done those crowdfunding campaigns which were successful. That's how Kickstarter did it, and that's why probably we're many the largest platform worldwide. Yeah. But people will have to find their little niches on platform. I think that will certainly be going on for still a few years. I don't see consolidation coming up in the next year.
Yeah, and one last final question. When you look at, especially also from your point of expertise, there was some discussion also about Kickstarter, where ends the responsibility of a platform and where starts the responsibility of the entrepreneur?
That's a very legal question.
Do you have something to say about that?
Well, basically, it's, you see the big platforms, they are very well documented. So these risks are, if you look into the nitty-gritty, they are very clearly written out. And I think that is also a task of the platforms to communicate that very well, that they are just an intermediary and that you are investing into real-life seed capital project which can go bust. And as long as they communicate that well, I think the platforms can be protected. And just place one example. I was in Crowdcube yesterday in the UK. You have to fill in MiFID compliant surveys, and one of the questions is always, when my startup goes bust, will QuietKube pay me back? And you have to click it, you have to say no, otherwise you cannot just invest in that.
Yeah.
So that regulatory laws have filtered in the investing process there, and I think that's quite impressive. And
yeah.
We'll have to go that way.
And also with some lending platforms in the Netherlands, you see that depending on the platform, that as an entrepreneur, you're also responsible for yourself. So even if you have a BV, like you say in Holland, you're personal responsible for the money you lend through crowdfunding. Yeah.
All depending on the structure that you use, you are correct. What we see in Belgium, you see the same structures here, where basically the platforms go in between and they issue their own products, which they use to invest in the startups. Who knows, will that model survive? Because it's indeed what we see in Belgium and the Netherlands, or will we go to more really intermediary companies who are just in between and do not take up that role?
Okay. So I'm looking forward to the future and also to your story. Thank you for the interview and good luck on stage today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.